There's a letter from Wynonna Judd, because I named her Wynonna.
You named her?
Uh-huh. Her name was Christina.
Really?
Yeah. So that's another story.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay, well, you're going to leave me hanging on the name here, are you?
You want me to tell you the whole story?
Go for it. I mean, why not?
Oh, okay, sure, because
sure
it's going to be out.
People listening going, well, yeah, hello.
Well, I kept it. I never shared this with anybody for years because I didn't want to capitalize on my relationship with her and with Naomi.
Uh-huh.
And, you know, I was Naomi. I was dating her and seeing her and during that time when I was with The Wheel. She lived in California. And I was up at their house, and Christina was about 15 at the time.
Mm-hmm.
And so I was teaching her how to play guitar. She was learning how to play guitar and sing and stuff. And so Naomi told me one day, she said, Christina's really talented, and she's going to be special. She's going to be, I think she's going to be famous. And I said, yeah, I think she's got it, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And she said, well... But she needs a stage name. I said, well, let me think about that. And so a couple of weeks later, I left to join the band, and we were playing up at the Shy Clown, remember that place, man, in Reno. Yeah. And we always stayed at the sweetest motel in Truckee, right on the Truckee River. Had the best little restaurant and everything. But anyhow, Naomi drove up a couple weeks later in her red 57 Chevy to come up and spend a few days. And we, so I had thought about it, you know, and I said, because Christina, even when she was young, she really loved the blues stuff. She'd say, man, Johnny, play that blues song, play that blues stuff. Mm-hmm. She really dug the blues, you mm-hmm. know. And when she'd sing, she was really, you know, she was kind of put it out there. And I was like, wow, man. So I thought about Wynonna Harris. And he was a great blues shouter, an R&B guy in the 40s and 50s. And the counterpart in the black community, the name was there was a lot of women who were named Wynonna. Wynonna Carr was a famous piano player, mm-hmm. jazz and boogie woogie piano player. And so I just said, yeah, Wynonna. And I told Naomi, and she said, oh, I really like that, you know. So she said, well, let me see what Christina thinks. And so anyhow, we went on our way, and about a month later or so later, I was back in Austin, and I got a card. And it was like all hand decorated, the outside of the envelope and the inside, the card. And it said, Dear Johnny, my favorite person, everybody loves my new name. Don't ever forget that you gave me that name.
Yes,
and blah, blah, blah. And Wynonna. And she had it was really sweet. It was a Valentine's card, and she had little hearts and lips and everything on it that she did with her hand. And I just saved that card. Years later, this rumor got around because that people go, well, how did she get named? And she kind of knew, but you know how things happen. And those girls were, you know, then got famous and mm-hmm. all this stuff. So the story came about that she had been named about the town in California.
What?
In the song Route 66.
And you're like, no.
Because we were connected with, you know, I sang Route 66,
yeah,
and
yeah.
and they knew there was a connection between me and Naomi. Don't forget Wynonna. Well, that had nothing to do with it, but that story was propagated and put out there, and yeah. It stuck. It's even in that new podcast, kind of that Cocaine and Rhinestones podcast on the Judds. But all of that's fixing to change because
okay.
I talked to Wynonna last winter. I said, you know, this thing needs to be out. It's too significant. And we talked about it. She said, yeah, you know, I know that story about Route 66. That didn't sound right. I said, well, let me send you something. So I took pictures of the card and sent it to her. And she said, oh, my God, I remember when I was blah, blah, blah. And she said, that's so cool. And I told her about Wynonna Harris.
Mm-hmm.
And she Googled him up and checked it out, and she flipped. She loved him, you know, and she was like, oh, she was so happy. And I said, yeah, aren't you glad you weren't named after some diddly little town in California, Wynonna. Nothing against Wynonna, the town, yeah, but it had nothing to do with her name.
I'm glad you said it straight. That is cool.
And the card is now going to be, it's at the, in Nashville, it's going to be in the Country Music Hall of Fame.
Fun.
With the Judd's exhibit that starts this month, later this month.
That's cool. Yeah. Well, good for you. I'm glad it was said straight. You get the record straight.
It's a good story, you know?